pieces, and then we'll call some of the other folks that are going to sing for us this evening.
It didn't make the papers in this world when I prayed through. It didn't seem to matter to all but just a few. But in the golden streets of glory, celebration voices raised. Yes, it made the news in heaven that night when I got saved. Angels were rejoicing, hallelujahs rang, when Jesus touched my life and I was changed. Everyone in glory's realm, in my name was written down. Yes, it made the news in heaven that night when I got saved. Not long ago, now a child of the King, this old world shrugged its shoulders. To them it didn't mean a thing. But it was God's approval my spirit really craved, and it made the news in heaven when I got saved. Angels were rejoicing, hallelujahs rang, when Jesus touched my life and I was changed. Everyone in glory's realm, in my name was written down. Yes, it made the news in heaven that night when I got saved. Yes, it made the news in heaven that night when I got saved.
It made the news in heaven that night when I got saved. And just
what a beautiful thought I was thinking concerning that great speckled bird. Remember her name is recorded on the pages of God's holy word. All the other birds flocking around her, and she is despised by them all. For the great speckled bird in the Bible represents you and I, the Church of God. They desire her to lower and they watch every move that she made. They seek to find fault in her teaching, but in Christ in the morning. She will meet her dear Lord in the sky. I'm so glad I'm a part of that number that will see my dear Savior face to face. And I'll sing in his presence forever. Praise the Lord for his great redeeming grace. Praise the Lord for his great redeeming grace.
Now, we're very delighted to have with us this evening our sister Nell. She's sitting behind us, and her sister comes the whole way from Bangor. And we're very glad to have her here in Cookstown this evening. Put your hands, please, together and give our sister Nell a very, very warm welcome. And, of course, with Nell, there is her daughter, Lorraine. So give Lorraine a very welcome, a warm welcome as well.
Well, now, we nearly didn't make it to Cookstown tonight. We were in Ocker-Clocker, 5 mile town. Now, that's not far down the road. I don't know, we must have missed a turning or something, but we ended up in Clocker, and I asked this gentleman, he says to me, you're miles from it there. He says, you need to go way back down. So anyway, here we are. We've gotten good time, so. But I want to tell you a wee story tonight. And this little story is about a wee boy. And the pastor was coming to the house to visit, and he was very bold and very bad. And the mommy says to him, Jimmy, you go in the sitting room, the pastor's coming, and you stay there. So wee Jimmy was in the sitting room, and the pastor went up to the door, the mother said, Your Reverence, you wouldn't mind going in. Jimmy's in the sitting room, and he'll keep you occupied. So wee Jimmy was sitting there, and the pastor sat down beside him. He says, Jimmy, tell me something, do you like school? Oh, he says, I love it. He says, what about your spelling and your reading, do you like it? Oh, great, he says, I'm doing well at it. He says, Jimmy, can I ask you a wee question? He says, what is it? He says, what are we having for dinner? Wee Jimmy says, we're having goat. He says, goat? How do you know that, son? Well, he says, my mother and father were doing the dishes last night. I heard my mother saying that old goat's coming for dinner tomorrow.
Now all you need are the voices and the singers to be singing. It's a song already given, waits the voices to be sung. All the peoples together singing, their voices uniting praises. And the armies of God, today has begun. You are my inspiration, you give me joy in the morning. And the song that I'm singing rises to find its light in thee. And this song that you gave me, Lord, no one can take away. It's my song of praise, my song of victory. Perhaps you haven't seen it, don't let it pass you by. If there's something you've been waiting for, well, I'm here to tell you why. The Lord expects your praises, it's something of a mystery. And he really longs to give you spiritual eyes to see. You are my inspiration, you give me joy in the morning. And the song that I'm singing rises to find its light in thee. And this song that you gave me, Lord, no one can take away. It's my song of praise, my song of victory. You are my inspiration you give me, joy in the morning, and the song that I'm singing rises to find its light in thee. And this song that you gave me, Lord, no one can take away. It's my song of praise, my song of victory. It's my song of praise, my song of victory.
You know, when you've got the Lord tonight,
my hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood, his righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but wholly lean on Jesus' name. On Christ's song, lid rock I stand. All other ground is sinking sand. On Christ's song, lid rock I stand. All other ground is sinking sand. When darkness seems to veil his face, I rest on his unchanging grace. In every hard and stormy gale, my anchor holds within the veil. On Christ's song, lid rock I stand. All other ground is sinking sand. On Christ's song, lid rock I stand. All other ground is sinking sand. His oath is carved and the blood. Support me in the whelming flood. When all around my soul gives way, he then is all my hope and stay. On Christ's song, lid rock I stand. All other ground is sinking sand. On Christ's song, lid rock I stand. All other ground is sinking sand.
Just one little piece to finish this end of the program. And I'm glad tonight that there is a Redeemer, and he's Jesus, God's own Son. He's precious to me tonight because he's a Lamb of God, the Messiah, the Holy One.
There is a Redeemer, Jesus, God's own Son. He's precious, Lamb of God, Messiah, Holy One. Thank you, oh my Father, for giving us your Son and leaving your Spirit to the work on earth is done. Jesus, my Redeemer, name above all names, His precious Lamb of God, Messiah, of foreseen name.
The privilege of being able to spread the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ, and we're told in the scriptures that we're not only to tell it to our children, but also to our children's children. We thank God that not only have we the good news that the Lord Jesus came, but we have the good news that Jesus Christ is coming again. This same Jesus, and thank God he'll come in like manner as you have seen him go. Tell your children and your children's children of that second coming of the King. And thank God the Lord Jesus Christ is coming. And for those that love him, they can say, and he's coming for me.
Tell your children and your children's children of the second coming of the King. Stand upon the mount of fathers, salvation to a dying world to bring.
Blow ye the trumpet of Zion, our Lord is coming back to earth again. In the holy mountain sound the warning to the ones who wear the yoke of sin. So tell your children and your children's children of the second coming of the King. He will stand upon the Mount of Olives, salvation to the dying world to bring. Now Daniel prophesied in all his wisdom, if we fail to walk the righteous path, it would be too late to beg for mercy at the dawning of the day of wrath. Tell your children and your children's children of the second coming of the King. He will stand upon the Mount of Olives, salvation to the dying world to bring.
how in the blessed word of God it's written, Jesus said, I'll come again for thee. I'm glad I plunged beneath the precious fountain, and the blood of Jesus Christ, it covers me. So tell your children and your children's children of the second coming of the King. He will stand upon the Mount of Olives, salvation to the dying world to bring. So tell your children and your children's children of the second coming of the King. He will stand upon the Mount of Olives, salvation to the dying world to bring. He will stand upon the Mount of Olives, salvation to the dying world to bring.
He will stand upon the Mount of Olives, salvation to the dying world to bring. Thank God then, those that love heaven means to me.
Country where the twilight shadows deepen, unending day where night will never be. A city where the storm clouds ever gather. Oh, this is just what heaven means to me. What joy 'twill be when we get over yonder and join the throng around the crystal sea, to meet our loved ones and crown Christ forever. Oh, this is just what heaven means to me. See the face of Jesus before whose glory other loves all flee. And when they crown him Lord of all, I'll be there. For this is just what heaven means to me. What joy 'twill be when we get over yonder and join the throng around the crystal sea, to meet our loved ones and crown Christ forever. Oh, this is just what heaven means to me. What joy 'twill be when we get over yonder and join the throng around the crystal sea, to be. Oh, this is
tonight to have a group of young men sitting.
Shackled by a heavy burden, 'neath the load of guilt and shame, then the hand of Jesus touched me.
I've walked this weary road of life with a burden on my back. I've tried so hard, I've fell so far, I've got way off track. Then Jesus came in a special way. He took my heavy load. Now I can say save your soul if you put him
wash away your sin, and you can sing this song. Thank you, Lord, for dying on Calvary. Thank you, Lord, for giving your life so free. Thank you, Lord, for peace and serenity. Thank you, Jesus, for all you've done for me. Thank you, Lord, for peace and serenity. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus, for all you've done for me.
Who I'm really singing about, but if the shoe fits, just put it on.
In country, town, or city, wherever man is found, folks spend their time grumbling at everyone around. Oh yes, they always grumble, no matter what we say. These are chronic grumblers, and they grumble night and day. Oh, they grumble on a Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, grumble on a Thursday too. Grumble on a Friday, Saturday, Sunday, grumble the whole week through. Grumble on a Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, grumble on a Thursday too. And they grumble on a Friday, Saturday, Sunday, grumble the whole week through. Well, they grumble in the city, and they grumble on the farm. They grumble at their neighbors, they really think it is no harm. They grumble at the husband, then he grumbles at the wife. They grumble at their children, they're old grumblers all their lives. Oh, they grumble on a Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, grumble on a Thursday too. And they grumble on a Friday, Saturday, Sunday, grumble the whole week through. They grumble on a Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, grumble on a Thursday too. And they grumble on a Friday, Saturday, Sunday, grumble the whole week through. Well, they grumble when it's raining, and they grumble when it's dry. They grumble if the crops fail, they grumble and they sigh. They grumble at low prices, and they grumble when they're high. They spend their life grumbling, they'll grumble till they die. Oh, they grumble on a Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, grumble on a Thursday too. And they grumble on a Friday, Saturday, Sunday, grumble the whole week through. They grumble on a Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, grumble on a Thursday too. And they grumble on a Friday, Saturday, Sunday, grumble the whole week through. Yes, they grumble the whole week through.
They grumble the whole week through. I wonder. Is there a mountain that I need to climb? Is there a valley you want to make mine? Is there a river I need to cross through? Whatever it takes, I'm willing to face, to be close to you. Dear Lord, I believe with all of my heart that the old rugged cross gave me a new start. But each day I need the touch of your hand and
and I'm willing to do and to go through anything you command. Is there a mountain that I need to climb? And is there a valley you want to make mine? Is there a river I need to cross through? Whatever it takes, I'm willing to face, to be close to you.
I know it's very easy to say that when things are going well. And you're up there in the top of the mountain of laughter and joy. Birds of life are singing in the trees. But life's not always like that, friend. There are also valleys that we have to walk into. Yet the Lord says, I'll never leave you. Lord, whatever it takes, I'm willing to face to be close to you.
I want to be in your perfect will. If it takes a mountain, if it takes a hill, remove anything that stands in the way. Whatever the price, the sacrifice, dear God, I pray. Is there a mountain that I need to climb? And is there a valley you want to make mine? Is there a river I need to cross through? Whatever it takes, I'm willing to face, to be close to you.
May God help us to say that, to sing it, and to really mean it with all of our hearts. Is there a valley? Before Sharon sings for us, Vivian's sitting back here. And I'm going to ask Vivien to bring us a wee recitation at this time, just to change. Ladies and gentlemen, our sister Vivien is going to recite for us. Put your hands together, please.
No, I was looking down over the congregation there just before the lights went down. And you know, some people have hair here. Some people have it here and some people have it up here. But you know, every morning we get up, don't you look in the mirror and say to yourself, I'm really going down the hill. Who says to themselves every morning, I'm really going down the hill? Well, you know, I brought a wee poem tonight, and after I read this wee poem, you'll be going out saying, boys, wasn't that great? I feel a lot younger now. Because I read it to myself every morning. I say to myself, now as the pains and aches grow and as I get older, and looking at some people behind me here too, like the Reverend McCrea, his hair is really going. Oh, here he's coming.
Hair and brains both. Vivien,
but you know, this is a
good sign. Seen a donkey bald.
I know, that's true. But you know, it's a nice sign too, that the nearer we are to heaven, the older we get, and it's lovely. You know, if you're really a Christian, you're really looking forward to go up through the clouds into heaven. And just listen to this wee poem. It's, what is a senior citizen worth? And you might say, I'm worth nothing. But just listen to this wee poem, and you'll be saying, I'm worth a lot. We are worth a fortune. With silver in her hair, gold in her teeth, stones in her kidneys, and lead in her feet. We now have two men to see us every day. As soon as we get up, willpower helps us out of bed. Then arthritis shows up and stays around all day. He doesn't like to stay in one place, so he moves from joint to joint. The rector called the other day and said that at our age, we should be thinking of the hereafter. We do it all the time, no matter where we go. In the kitchen, living room, or up the stairs we go. We stand and say, now what am I here after?
Vivien,
Doesn't that make you feel good now? You say to yourself, I feel great now. But you know, I didn't always come from Bangor. I really come from Lochfine, away up near Newcastle, Hilltown, up that way. And you know, my daddy gets up every morning at 6:30 to make sure that he gives the postman his breakfast. And I'm sure down here in Cookstown, you all do that. Who here all gets up to make the postman their breakfast at 6:30 in the morning? Hands up, who gives the postman their breakfast? Not a one. It's not a shame. Well, neither do I, nor neither does Nell. Now, maybe there's some poor postman here tonight, is there? Is there no postman here tonight? Well, dear, help them out that wintry mornings. It's terrible getting up and no breakfast. But, you know, it's nice to be able to do a wee job like that for the Lord. And, you know, my daddy thinks that's a wee job for the Lord. And so it is, a wee job for the Lord. The little it is, whenever God is in it, it's all for him. And, you know, it mightn't even be doing that. It might be just running a wee message for the neighbour down the street or doing some wee message or some wee thing. Mightn't even be doing that. Maybe just sitting in your own wee corner just to have a wee word of prayer. And just listen to this wee poem and you'll see why I told you that wee story. She lived in the house in the country. 'Twas always so tidy and neat. She was house proud, and anyone calling would guiltily wipe their feet. One night as she slept, she heard voices which seemed to be so far away. They told her Christ would be calling, calling to see her next day. She rose very early next morning. There were so many jobs she must do. For if Christ was coming to see her, the house must be cleaned right through. She polished and dusted all morning. Then hearing a knock on the door, she found there a child on her doorstep. Her knees were bleeding and sore. Please can you help me, she whispered. My mummy's out shopping today. I've no time to help, the lady replied. No time at all. Go away. She'd only to clean the windows now. Then all would be spick and span. But suddenly, walking toward her, came a bent old frail man. A tramp who was living rough, he said, and cold and hungry that day. Could you give me a drink of water to help me on my way? Oh, why don't you try next door, she said. I'm sure they will give it to you. There's a visitor calling here today, and I have so much to do. At last, all was ready for Jesus. She sat down to wait for his call. But the hours rolled on, and by midnight, no visitor called, none at all. So she slept, and a voice whispered softly, I have called on you twice today. 'Twas I who called, and that child and that tramp, and twice you turned me away. May we all take a lesson from this, my friends, and always be willing to help a soul in need, no matter who, for it may be Christ himself.
Thank you very much indeed, Vivien. And now Sharon's going to sing for us, and the first piece she's going to sing is Where Can I Go But to the Lord.
Comfort I get from God's own word. suppose God searched through heaven. He couldn't find one willing to be the supreme sacrifice that was needed just to buy eternal life for you.
Nailed my Lord to a tree. My all in all. redeemed me from sin and shame. Now he will keep me. Praise his name. Someday I know he'll take me where he is to
Thank you very much indeed, Brother Ivan. Now we're going to have a little break just for about.
And also George Hamilton the Fourth is also coming, and then both of them have kindly to come to sing in the City Hall free, and that they would, all the money that we raise will go to our Spina Bifida. Now the price is a bit dear, maybe, I don't know, but I hope you don't mind. The price is for people £12, and for senior citizens and children £8. And if you like, we're hoping that the Ulster Hall here will sell them. And also, I'm going to ask, and I see one here, I'm going to ask her if to sell them in the Bethel, and my daughter's shopping on street as well, and to get them out. We can only see about 900 people, but I would say if you could come and help us to raise this money for these children, I would appreciate it. Thank you.
Night. Can I say this to you tonight, that I do want you to take this. This is on the 1st of December, 1st of December of this year. Now, it is a very special appeal. You know that all the money is going to Spina Bifida, and these children need your help. And I want you to really do this. I know you may be putting yourself out to do this, to buy those tickets, but listen, remember, it's not for anyone else. It is for the children who endure the affliction for many times or many years of Spina Bifida. We want to help them. Now, the Belfast City has been in a relationship now with Nashville. They are now looking to have a bond with Nashville and a twinning with Nashville. And so therefore, when the Lord Mayor asked us, we then put out a request that as it's Belfast and Nashville, or Northern Ireland and Nashville, to be twinned together, then that I would make a request to George Hamilton the Fourth to come and share it, Nashville and Belfast. I'm delighted to say that he has agreed, and therefore on the 1st of December we will have that. I trust you'll be there too. Thank you very much indeed. Lord Mayor. Let's have a little break. Just 5 minutes' time, 5-10 minutes at the most, we'll be back. Get into your seats and we're going to start our second part and final.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Ivan, what happened to you, Ivan?
In this way, by and by.
competition.
We're going to have this side singing that verse. Ivan, you're headmaster, judicator, examiner. You're them all rolled into one. He's deaf in both ears. Right. And on this side, now you keep quiet because we're coming to you. So, are you ready, folks? Let's have you. There's a lad folks. Can you hear this? There's a supposed to be judging, and I looked over when they were singing, and there he was singing away. Disqualified. Yes, that was very good singing, I must confess. This must stand to our feet and we'll sing. Then let us sing on that beautiful shore. Let's everybody stand together.
We shall sing on that beautiful shore. And melodious songs of the blessed,
and their spirits shall sorrow no more.
Not a sigh for the blessing of breath.
Lift it up now.
In the sweet by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore. It's a highway to heaven. None can walk up there but the pure in heart. It's a highway to heaven. I'm walking up the King's highway. There's joy in knowing with Him I'm going, walking up the King's highway. My load is brighter, my path will ladder, walking up the King's highway. It's a highway to heaven. None can walk up there but the pure in heart. It's a highway to heaven. I'm walking up the King's highway. If you're not walking, start while I'm talking, walking up the King's highway. You'll find a blessing, you'll be possessing, walking up the King's highway. It's a highway to heaven. None can walk up there but the pure in heart. It's a highway to heaven. I'm walking up the King's highway. For Christ you're living and gladly giving, walking up the King's highway. One day to greet Him, with loved ones meet Him, walking up the King's highway. It's a highway to heaven. None can walk up there but the pure in heart. It's a highway to heaven. I'm walking up the King's highway. It's a highway to heaven. None can walk up there but the pure in heart. It's a highway to heaven. I'm walking up the King's highway. Walking up the King's highway.
Whenever we get to the end of the journey, thank God, then it's home. And it's lovely to know. Certainly good to know that you're headed to heaven and to home.
Home is where the heart is. My heart's on home. Even though I never had one to call my own. But I've been given the key by my Savior of Calvary. The interest paid and the titles made to me.
Home,
where there is no night.
Home,
where the sun is the light. The place I've been dreaming of so long. Loved ones stand to welcome me, but His sweet face will be the first I'll see. When my journey's over, I am going home. Everybody dreams of going home, it seems. Lately I am no exception to the rule. But home is so much more than windows, walls, and doors. It's a warm embrace and the smiling face is awaiting you.
Home,
where there is no night.
Home,
where the sun is the light. The place I've been dreaming of so long.
Home,
loved ones stand to welcome me. But his sweet face will be the first I'll see. When my journey's over, I am going home. Home,
where there is no night.
Home,
where the sun is the light.
Place I've been dreaming of so long. Loved ones stand to welcome me, but the Savior's face will be the first I'll see. When my journey's over, I am going home. When my journey's over, I am.
My journey's over. Thank God I am going home. This world is not my home. I'm just a passing through.
I like the thrill and the feel when we get together with God's wonderful people. I like the thrill and the feel when we get together with God's wonderful people. What a sight just to see you, the happy faces. Praising the Lord, heavenly places, what a thrill and a feel when we get together with God's wonderful people. You can be just anywhere, two or three are gathered there, and the Spirit of the Lord can be there too. So sweet, no thrill that can compete. Whenever we meet with God's great family, I like a thrill that I feel when I get together with God's wonderful people. I like a thrill that I feel when we get together with God's wonderful people. What a sight just to see the happy faces praising the Lord.
Tears to dim the eye. All is peace.
sickness, no more pain, no more parting over there. And forever I will be with the one who died for me. What a day, glorious day, oh that will be. What a day that will be when my Jesus
Jesus every day of my life.
for I found He alone can really satisfy and deliver me from all of sin and strife. Yes, it's Jesus, the only one. Jesus, God's own dear Son. Yes, it's Jesus that set my soul free. It's Jesus Christ that's coming back for me. If you're looking for life, stop looking right now. It is Jesus that can give life to you. So just open your heart and unlock the door. Let Jesus cleanse your life through and through. It is Jesus, the only one. Jesus, God's own dear Son. Yes, it's Jesus that set my soul free. It's Jesus Christ that's coming back for me. Yes, it's Jesus, the only one. Jesus, God's own dear Son. Yes, it's Jesus that set my soul free. It's Jesus Christ that's coming back for me. It is Jesus Christ that's coming back for me.
Well, we had Sharon singing the first half, and I'm going to call she's my eldest girl, and now my older boy is going to sing, and he's going to sing. Finding out now exactly what he's going to sing, Where the Roses Never Fail.
I am going to gold are laid, where the tree of life is blooming and the roses never fade. Here they bloom but for a season. Soon beauty is decay. I am going to a city where the roses never fade. In this world we have our troubles, Satan's snares we must evade. We'll be free from all temptations where the roses never fade. But for a season, soon their beauty is decay. I am going to a city where the roses never fade. With Jesus.
of white array. Now they're waiting for my coming, where the roses never fade. Here they bloom but for a season. Soon their beauty is decayed. I am going to a city where the roses never fade.
The last piece that I'm going to sing is I'm Standing on the Solid Rock. Through my disappointment, strife and discontentment, I cast my every care on the Lord. No matter what obsession, pain or deep depression, standing on the solid rock. I'm standing on the rock of ages, safe from all the storms that rage, but not from Satan's wages. I'm standing on the solid rock. Even though he's gone now, I don't feel alone now. Came the Spirit of the Lord. Now with His word to guide me, from temptations hide me, I'm standing on the solid rock. I'm standing on the rock of ages, safe from all the storms and rages. I'm rage, but not from Satan's wages. I'm standing on the solid rock. Now I'm pressing onward, each step leads me homeward. I'm trusting in my Savior day by day. Close is our relation, firm is its foundation, so on this solid rock I stay. I'm standing on the rock of ages, safe all the storms and rages. I'm rich, but not from Satan's wages. I'm standing on the solid rock. I'm standing on the rock of ages, safe from all the storms and rages. I'm rich, but not from Satan's wages. I'm standing on the solid rock. I'm standing on the solid rock.
I'm standing on the solid rock. Now
step into the water, the water, wait a little bit, a little deeper, bit deeper. When you're in the water of His love, oh, step into the water, wait a little bit deeper. Come join angels singing praises to the Lamb of God, to the Lamb of God. It is time that we, the people, stand up for what is right. It's time we squared our shoulders back and we raised our swords to fight. For the Bible is my weapon and the Spirit is my shield. The church needs more of its members to be workers in the field.
Oh, step into the water, wait out a little bit deeper, wet your feet in the water of His love. Oh, step into the water, wait out a little bit deeper, come join angels singing praises to the Lamb of God, to the Lamb of God. There is victory for the Christian who walks a narrow way. There has been a prize appointed for the soul who does not stray. Oh, I want to live for Jesus, be all that I should be, so that I can rest with Him forever and eternally. Oh, step into the water, wait out a little bit deeper, wet your feet in the water of His love. Oh, step into the water, wait out a little bit deeper, come join angels singing praises to the Lamb of God.
Hear those glad bells ringing. Come join angels singing praises to the Lamb of God.
This last piece we're going to sing is entitled, I Can See the Hand of the Father.
The hand of the Father in the valley so deep and the river so wide. I can see the hand of the Father.
I can see the hand
when I look around me.
I can hear the voice
blowing in the winds. I can feel the mighty touch of the Father's love. Touch of the Father in the snow that falls on a cold winter's night. I can feel the touch of the Father.
I can see the hand
when I look around me.
I can hear the
voice.
I can feel the mighty touch of the Father.
Everywhere I go,
His presence.
I can see the hand, I can hear the voice, I can feel the touch. I can see the hand, hear the voice, I can feel the touch. I can see the hand, hear the voice, I can feel the touch of God.
Well, I am. It's really good. You know, the Lord loves a laugh, doesn't he? Really, he does. If you know the Lord loves a laugh. And why don't you come tonight? If you don't know the Lord, you should come tonight and just sample it for yourself, and you'll see that you can have a laugh. You know the way Nell tells the jokes, or Reverend McCrea tells the jokes, and we can all have a wee laugh. The Lord says we're not to run about with a long face. We're to show the world that he belongs to us, and we can have a wee laugh. Why don't you come tonight and let the Lord fill you with the water of life? When we first say to Jesus, come into my heart, then the joys, the blessings, the loving will start. He carries our burden, shares our woes and our strife. He sends us his helper, the water of life. When the water of life fills our heart to the brim, sorrow and sadness no longer stay in. Come and pray to your maker, begin a new life. O Lord, keep me filled with the water of life. Sometimes we stumble, we slip and we sin. We spill precious water, none flows back in. Ask the Lord for forgiveness, hide not from above. Once more you'll be filled with the water of love. Be loving to others, ease sadness or pain. Share God's precious water like soft, gentle rain. Lean over and comfort, you'll find when you do, God's precious water will flow over from you. As God's precious water pours into your heart, like sparkling clear water, fresh from the start. Don't let it grow stagnant or just seep away. Pray to your maker, be filled every day.
I'm sure you heard about how the Jimmy went over to the United States of America, and he went and he was told, of course, it was the land of the rich and the free. It was a great place of opportunity. No place like it in all the world. That was the place to be. He went away to the United States of America, and when he arrived there, he was there about 2 weeks, and nobody looked the direction he was on. He felt so lonely. And you know, he was going to write, he wrote a wee letter home, and he says, "Dear Mother, having a wonderful time. Everyone is so wonderful. They tell you every day, have a nice day." And he says, "See you soon. Love, Jimmy." But you know, after he had sent the letter on, he realized that he had done nothing else only tell a big bundle of lies. Because no matter who he spoke to, they turned their head the other way. He was lying out on the bench. He had no more money left. And he's lying on the bench and he says, "I'm so hungry. Will nobody give me anything to eat?" And nobody did. So this day he decided he would have to look for a job. They turned him down, here, there, and yonder. Until one day, finally, he walked into the store, very downhearted. And he said to the man, "Would you please give me a job?" He says, "I have only one job alone. If you want it, you can take it. You can have it for your own." He says, "What is it? What is your job?" He says, you can sell oranges. He says, "What?" He says, "You can sell oranges." He says, "How could I sell oranges?" He says to you Yanks out here. He says, "I wouldn't know what to say." He says, "It's very simple." He says, "You spread your oranges out on the table. And as you spread them out on the table, you just say to them, 2 for 8. That means 2 for 8 cents. And he says, "Would that get them sold?" He says, "Yes." He says, "Maybe somebody will come along and say to you," he says, "they're very small." You just say in reply, "Some are and some aren't. 2 for 8, some are and some aren't." He says, "Will that get them sold?" He said, "Well," he says, "maybe they'll come and say, not today." You just reply, "Well, if you don't, someone else will. So 2 for 8, some are and some aren't. If you don't, somebody else will." So there was Jimmy, and he walks into the place and he says, "Now, how am I going to do this?" He spread all the oranges out, and all of a sudden this big Yank walks through the door. He says, "Hi, young man, tell me," he says, "what is the time?" Jimmy says, 2 for 8. American looks at him and he says, young man, he says, do you think that we Yanks are fools? And Jimmy says, some are and some aren't. He says to him, for two pins, he says, I would just give you a smacker up the gob. And Jimmy looks, he says, well, if you don't, somebody else will. You know, there was this wee boy, he went to school, and when he went to school, he was always, did you ever feel that you were picked on? Well, anyhow, this wee boy, he went to school, and the teacher, she decided she would ask some Bible questions, you know, just to find out whether it was Bible knowledge, how rich they were in Bible knowledge. And she looked down into the class and she said to him, Johnny, could you tell me who knocked down the walls of Jericho? And wee Johnny says, please, miss, it wasn't me. The teacher was absolutely distracted to hear a stupid little boy, a simple little question, who knocked down the walls of Jericho? He says, please, miss, it wasn't me. She was absolutely livid. She says, well, you see, when that boy's mother comes here to collect me, I will speak to her. And I will tell her how disgusting her son is. So anyhow, the mother came, and she was coming in to collect her little Johnny. She says, good afternoon to the teacher. She says, good afternoon. Could I have a word with you, please? Oh, yes, certainly. Johnny, you come in with me. What's wrong? What's wrong? The teacher said, I asked your son a simple question. Do you know what I asked your son? I asked your son, who knocked down the walls of Jericho? Do you know what he said to me? Do you know what he said to me? Please, miss, it wasn't me. Well, the mother, she sat in the room and she said, well, let me tell you, if my Johnny said he didn't do it, he didn't do it, for he's not a liar. Well, absolutely, she couldn't believe it. Here was not only a stupid boy, but here was a stupid mother too. Well, she went in, the teacher was frozen at the mouth, and she went into the headmaster of the school, and she sat down. Let me tell you, she says, these stupid children that are in the school and their parents are just as stupid as they are. Oh, he says, Miss Johnson, just, you know, settle down. What has got you so distraught? Do you know this? I had a little boy in my class. And I asked him a simple little question. Who knocked down the walls of Jericho? Do you know what he said? Do you know what he said to me? Please, miss, it wasn't me. And I stopped the mother and I said to the mother, how about what the boy said? Do you know what she said to me? She said to me, well, I know my Johnny, and if he said he didn't do it, he didn't do it. And my Johnny's not a liar. Headmaster says, listen, Miss Johnson, please, please, please keep quiet. Would you find out how much it is to put the wall back up again and we'll get the board to pay it? You can't win, can you? Yes, the board was going to pay it. The title track of my new album is just simply entitled On a Journey. And we've been talking about that tonight, that we're on the journey to heaven and we're on the journey to home. And why isn't it a wonderful thing to know that your destination is really heaven? Just to be sure. What did the hymn writer say? Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine. We are on a journey. Destination's heaven. We are on a journey, destination's heaven. Every mile brings us closer home. We're gonna keep our eyes on Jesus, knowing that he'll lead us to that land where the streets are pure as gold. Walking together toward heaven, talking and singing about heaven. Brothers and sisters, members of the family of God, I can't wait to leave here. Don't you want to be there when the saints all go marching in? Some from every nation, what a celebration, hand in hand, together with the Lord. Those who've gone before us with the Lord will greet us as we walk through those gates of pearl. Gonna bow the knees before Him, worship and adore Him. It's the church forever with the Lord. Walking together toward heaven, talking and singing about heaven. Brothers and sisters, members of the family of God. I can't wait to leave here. Don't you want to be there when the saints all go marching in? Some from every nation, what a celebration, hand in hand, together with the Lord. I don't want to leave here. Don't you want to be there when the saints all go marching in? Some from every nation, oh what a celebration, hand in hand, together with the Lord.
Some from every nation,
what a celebration, hand in hand, together with the Lord, with the Lord. Amen. And the only reason that we're getting to heaven is because of what Jesus Christ did for us at the hill called Calvary. Tonight, as we draw our service to close, let's just remember this. The cost of my redemption was the cost of the precious blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. When He was on the cross, you know, I was on His mind. It's amazing to know that way back there in eternity, that we were thought of, for God so loved the world. And then God not only so loved us, but He gave His Son a ransom for us, that whosoever believeth in Him should not perish, but have everlasting life. You know, you can have tonight. You can have God's great gift purchased in the coinage of the blood of Jesus, eternal life. When He was on the cross, I was on His mind. I'm not on an ego trip from nothing on my own. I make mistakes and often slip, just common flesh and bone. But I'll prove someday just why I say I'm of a special kind. For when He was on the cross, I was on His mind. For He knew me, yet He loved me. He whose glory makes the heavens shine. So unworthy,
of such mercy. For when he was on the cross, I was on his mind. Thank God I was on his mind. The look of love was on his face, thorns were on his head. You know, blood was on the scarlet robe, stained a crimson red. Though his eyes were on the crowd, he looked head in time. For when he was on the cross, I was on his mind. Yes, he knew me, yet he loved me. He whose glory made the heavens shine, so unworthy of such mercy. For when he was on the cross, I was on his mind. For when he was on the cross, I was on his mind. When he was on the cross, I was on his mind. You know, tonight as we leave this hall and we make our ways to our separate homes, just remember this, that anything we are tonight and anything we have, it's only because of the Lord Jesus Christ. Where would I be tonight? I remember a dear old saint was dying. I went to see her in the Mid-Ulster Hospital. And the last conversation I had with her, I said, "Sister, how are you today?" And she said to me these words. She says, "You know, son, as you sing a wee hymn, what would I do without Jesus? He's the shepherd of my valley. I couldn't make it without Jesus." And friend, let me say tonight, neither can you. There's not one of us will ever make it to glory without the Lord Jesus Christ. For without the Lord Jesus, we're lost. Lost in time, lost in eternity. But praise God, in Christ we're saved, and in Christ we're secure. And so tonight, as I draw this evening to a close, let me just say to you again, you need the one that I needed, and that one is none other than Jesus. Without him, I could do nothing. Without him, I surely fail. Without him, life would be hopeless. But with Jesus, find God. Without him, I would be dying. Without him, I'd be enslaved. Without him, without say. Listen to these words. Jesus, my lovely Jesus, do you know him today? Turning him away, oh Jesus, my lovely Jesus, without him, how lost I would be.
You know, I grew up among many of you, and it's not always easy to stand before your own and tell them you need the Lord Jesus Christ. My friend, let me tell you tonight, there is no other way but Jesus.
Without him, my life
with me.
My lovely Jesus, do you know him today, or are you turning him away? Oh Jesus, my lovely
thank God, in Christ, and with Christ, you're safe for all eternity. Let's just finish with a wee word of prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank thee for this night of song and pray that you'll bless the word that has been brought. We thank thee for everyone that has taken part. Thank thee for every sister and every brother in Christ that has just come forward to do their part for Jesus. Realize that there's nothing in us. We have nothing to boast in but in the cross, work of the Lord Jesus. Now we pray that you'll bless those that will be benefiting from this evening. And we pray that our God, those that are laid aside and those that are weak in body, in the name of the Lord Jesus, wilt thou draw near. Grant them, our God, thy touch upon their frames. Help us to remember how blessed we are tonight. So richly blessed. Take us to our homes in safety. Please watch over us tonight. And if there's one that knows not the Lord Jesus, even tonight bring them to thy lovely Son and save them for time and eternity. In Jesus' name. Amen. Can we all just stand together just as we sing What a Day? One little chorus.
What a day that will be, when my Jesus I shall see, and I look upon his face, the one who saved me by his grace. Then he'll take me by the hand and lead me through the promised land. What a
last time, lift it up now, come on, sing it with all of your heart.
What a day that will be, when my Jesus
friend here is just going to say a wee word before we finish. Just be seated 1 second, and then you'll be on your way home.
I promise not to keep you long, but I've been asked just to make one or two comments as to the direction that the money's raised tonight would go. It's been a wonderful evening and a tremendous evening of gospel music and poetry, and we've thoroughly enjoyed it. What I'd like to say to you is this, that the monies used will go directly towards the patients and their carers, and we've got to preserve their dignity because the illness is a devastating one, and those of us who have had loved ones who have died from that, we just know how awful the illness is. Also, the money will also go towards research. And one pleasing note from research is that a new drug called Reupload has just been put on the market. Now, it's a little bit of optimism, but it's the start. And that is now being used by some people who have motor neuron disease. And it's been discovered that it's extending life for several months. But the cure is still required. I, at this moment in time, would like to thank the Reverend William McCrea and his guests here this evening. It has truly been a wonderful evening. I have enjoyed it so much. And Ivan, just to let you know, I'm also from Bangor, and it was well and truly worth the trip. I have thoroughly enjoyed the night, and I must say that myself and my wife have really been made so welcome among you here. We've enjoyed it so much indeed. And we'd also like to thank Dr. McGuinness, who has so kindly lent us this building tonight. It's very kind of him to do this and to help us in such a wonderful way. Now, we are a very small committee, extremely small committee, and we have to travel over the province. But that's our pleasure, because there are other people in the province, like Anne Murphy and her friends, who have arranged tonight for us. Now, there's one last group of people I must thank tonight, and that's you, who are all standing facing me, because tonight you have reached a tremendous sum of money, £1,537.99. On behalf of the Northern Ireland branch of Motor Neuron Disease Association, because we only do have the one branch in our province, I would like to thank you on their behalf for such a wonderful gesture. This is truly wonderful, and this has touched my heart, I can tell you very much indeed. And lastly, and I finish now, but please thank all the guests on platform behind me, because they have really served up a wonderful evening of music for us. Thank you so much.
In our pleasure to be here this evening, I trust your heart has been blessed. Could I just mention to you, next Saturday night, God willing, in the Ulster Hall, if there's anyone able to get down there, we're having a night where we have the Gospel Heirs, the Zion Heirs, the Kingdom Heirs. We're all heirs of the Kingdom anyhow. And a group of other folks that are going to be in something like, you know, the going home video, where we're all just going to get together and sing the praises of the Lord Jesus Christ. That's next Saturday evening in the Ulster Hall. Our sister Winnie out there, I think, has some tickets for that there. If you'd like to come and share with us, I know it's going to be a good evening. Friends, good night, and God bless you all. And most of all, if we don't meet here, be sure we'll meet in glory at the feet of Jesus. Good night, everybody, and God bless you all.
joys will never end. I'll fly away. I'll fly away, oh glory. I'll fly away in the morning when I die. Hallelujah, by and by. By and by.